Internet is a powerful tool that can do a lot of good, but as we often report, some people use it for the wrong reasons. Someone who had a grudge against an Albuquerque man recently used a popular site to embarrass him and put his family at risk. And as Kim Holland found out on special assignment, the man had a hard time getting the site to do anything about it.
I was receiving phone calls and text messages. They were asking about the Craigslist ad. I was shocked.
That was Manuel Romero's reaction when he realized his name and photo were on the internet for anyone to see. Without his consent, someone posted a personal ad on Craigslist that said he was seeking sex.
It was about the fourth ad. I had clicked into it and seen my photo.
And it was vulgar.
I need a real man that could handle this. Hosting a and go or an all-night thing.
But what's even worse, Romero's phone number and address were also listed.
I got 40 text messages and about 13 calls.
Then there were the cars that slowly drove by the house where Romero lives with his family.
And I was worried that they were going to start coming to my door and jeopardizing me and my family because my grandchildren came over too.
Romero, his mother, and even his friends flagged the ad and asked Craigslist to remove it. 13 flags, and a month later, it was still there, and the calls and texts kept coming.
Did you ever hear from Craigslist?
I've never heard from Craigslist. I tried to write an email to see if they would remove it, and they never contacted me back.
We tried too.
If you are calling about an issue related to free listings on Craigslist, including questions about flagging, harassment,
phone calls, emails, and even a fax. Finally, a Craigslist public relations firm emailed us a link on its homepage where users who have suffered abuse can fill out a form and report it. Romero and his mother say they never saw that link. And the ad only disappeared when it expired a month later. So what about the person who posted the ad?
Who do you think did this?
Somebody that I had conflicts with in my past. I believe I know who it is.
Police won't get involved because it's not considered criminal. So the only recourse Romero has is to sue the person he suspects for slander and defamation.
I just hope that people that do post Craigslist beware because you're endangering other people's lives.
In the meantime, he keeps checking back on Craigslist to make sure his personal information doesn't pop up again. Kim Holland, KRQE News 13.
Well, that really does stink. And, you know,
it's pretty scary.
Just being at Craigslist, never responded, never took the thing down, never.